Hi, I'm Matt Hintz, and I'm planning on doing a cover song for my project here. So far, we've been giving a lot of freedom, I feel like, to choose what we want to do for our topics for these projects, which I've really appreciated. And I decided to kind of stick with a music theme throughout the projects because I feel like I connect most with that. So I'm planning on doing, talking a little bit about my experiences with covers and like what covers are. And then I was going to do at the end, a cover for Green Day, Time of Your Life. So to start, I'm going to talk about what cover songs are. A cover song is a song or recording by someone other than the original artist or composer of the song. In some cases, a cover song is a recording of a song that was previously recorded by another artist. But in other cases, it may be a new recording of that song that was originally written and recorded by someone else. Cover songs are often recorded by artists to pay tribute to the other artists, or to put their own spin on a classic song. Cover songs can also be recorded to generate new interest in an artist or their music, which I like to do a lot with punk rock, which I feel like there has been somewhat of a lack of interest in recent years, but there's a lot of new artists popping up now. So with my experience with covers, I mean, I've done a lot of covers in the past for various bands, mostly punk rock, like I said before. Bands like Green Day do the ease of their songs. So Green Day's hits were some of the first songs I've ever learned to play on guitar, and they've helped me mold my skill set with guitar. A lot of their songs, earlier songs, are mostly just power chords. So when you're, I mean, when the main singer as well, I mean, everything that he would build, he would sing along with the guitar. He'd also be the lead guitarist traditionally back in the 90s. So a lot of his songs were pretty simple power chord, power chord notes, and very easy for first timers. So that has been my first exposure to learning to play guitar. I performed cover songs in school at talent shows and in front of my class several times in high school and middle school. I felt like it's a great way to express myself and my interests and pay respect to the bands like Green Day that had a big impact in my life, in my childhood. And here's an example. I was going to show you an example from my talent show back in middle school. I put in parentheses, caution cringe. It is very cringy. I mean, to look back at like older footage, I feel like that's a common thing for everyone, but I mean, the intro to this is what the hell. So I'm going to play that.
Thank you.
So, I think the personal effects for cover songs can vary. I think for some artists, recording a cover can be a way to conduct or to connect with their fans at a deeper level. It allows them to share their love of a particular song or artist. For other artists, recording a cover can also be a way to broaden their audience by exposing their music to new listeners. In some cases, an artist may choose to cover a song to simply because they enjoy the challenge of reinterpreting someone else's work. I think especially broadening your spectrum with guitar playing, like it helps to broaden your spectrum when learning a new skill set, when learning new chords on guitar, learning new exercises. So there's a whole bunch of different varieties of songs you can learn to play. And I mean, I haven't played in a while, you'll see, but I plan to get back into it soon. So the choice of instrument and the choice of music, I mean, the choice, it depends on which song you're planning on covering. It's often a personal one for the artist, and can be based on a variety of factors. Some artists may choose to cover a song that they have a personal connection to, while others may choose a song that they feel will resonate with their audience, the audience you're trying to reach. In some cases, an artist may choose to cover a song simply because they want to share it with their fans. I mean, it also depends on who your audience is. If you're playing a gig or something, they might not like your choice of music, and I mean, that always, always depends. So now, the legality of cover songs is something that's always interested me. The legality of cover songs can be a bit of a gray area. In some cases, an artist may choose to obtain a license from the original artist or composer to legally release the cover song. However, in other cases, a cover song may be considered fair use of the original song and no license would be required. So typically it depends on profit, it depends on how you are distributing the cover song. That's another part of the legality, but it's generally a gray area. Okay, so now I'm going to record a cover of Time of Your Life by Green Day. Again, I haven't played in a while. I'm still a little rusty. I'm not gonna sing. I'm gonna just do a guitar cover. So, I'm not much of a singer, although I used to be, but